Welcome students, today we will take up the topic probability in genetics. It is very important topic for the NET examination. Generally we have two or three questions of probability in the examination. So I will try to make you understand the topic in very easy way. Hope it will be beneficial for all of you. So first we should know what is the probability. It is the possible outcome of a trial or an experiment. For example, the toss of a coin or rolling of a die. The tossing of a coin is trial, or you can say experiment. And having head or tail is the event. Similarly, the rolling of a die, it is a trial. And getting the digit 1 to 6 is the event or the outcome. So by using probability, we can predict the likelihood of inheriting a particular traits and disease in the family lines, and also it is used to predict the outcome of crosses in the genetics. So before going into the detail of the topic, first we would like to understand the Mendelian law of inheritance. So here on the screen we are seeing the monohybrid cross. So what is monohybrid cross? In which we take up one gene for a character. So here we have taken the character of height. So if we cross two heterozygous parent for the gene T and observe the progeny, so there are four possible outcome of this fertilization event. So out of these four, if we see the homozygous star, the probability of homozygous star can be calculated 1/4. And probability of heterozygous star, if we see the checkerboard, the probability is 2/4 or 1/2. And if we see the homozygous dwarf, the probability of getting this is 1/4. This is the genotypic ratio. And if we observe the phenotypic ratio, then out of the four offsprings, three will be tall and one will be dwarf. So probability of getting tall is 3/4 and probability of getting dwarf is 1/4. Similarly, if we see here the crossing between two parent where one is homozygous for gene T, dominant T, capital T, and other is heterozygous star. And if we see the progeny, all will be tall, and the probability of getting homozygous star is 1/2 and heterozygous star is 1/2. And the third case where the cross take place between homozygous star and homozygous dwarf, and there is the probability of getting tall will be 1. So all will be tall. So how these probabilities can be calculated without using the checkerboard? We will learn it in our next slide. So here we have taken up one gene, and we are able to draw the Punnett square or checkerboard in very easy way. What would be a condition if the number of genes involved in a cross are more than 2. These may be 3, 4, 5. If you are taking 5 genes and in the checkerboard you have to draw the 1024 combination of the alleles, and it is very cumbersome. Then how can we make it easy? So there are certain rules regarding the determination of or getting the probability from a particular cross. So there are 3 mathematical operations which can be used to compute the probability without drawing the Punnett square or the checkerboard. These are the product rule, sum rule, and the binomial expansion equation. So what is the product rule or AND rule? It is also known by the multiplication rule. So if two event A and B, or we can take up X and Y, whatever you take. So if two event A and B must happen in order for a certain outcome to occur, and if A and B are independent of each other, means they are not affecting the likelihood of each other, then we use the product rule. So the probability of, means the combined probability of a particular event is equal to the multiplication of the probability of each event. We will understand it with the help of the example. So we are having 2 coins and we flip these 2 coins. What is the probability of getting head in both the cases? So if we toss 1 coin, then the probability of getting head is 1/2, because there are only 2 conditions, either you will get head or you will get tail. So probability of head and tail will remain 1/2. So getting head in one case will not affect the probability of having head in another case. So both the events, means getting head, are independent of each other. Okay, so here we will apply the product rule. So the probability of getting head in both the cases will be calculated by multiplying the probability of getting head in one event and probability of getting head in another event, means 1/2 multiply 1/2, that is 1/4. So this rule can be understood by taking the example of Mendel's first law, which state that there is the equal segregation of allele while the gamete formation takes place. So here this male parent, which is heterozygous for the gene T, when it produces gamete, each gamete receive a single allele, either capital T or small t. Okay, and the probability of getting capital T is 1/2, half, because there is equal segregation of alleles. And probability of getting small t is again half. Similarly, in case of female, when there is egg formation, probability of getting capital T and small t is also half. So both the event, here the event is the formation of the gametes with capital T in both the cases. So these are not affecting the likelihood of each other, both are independent cases. So if we would like to have the offspring with both capital T or both small t genotype, we will apply the product rule. So what is the probability of getting the capital T, both capital T? It will be the product of the probability of getting capital T in male gamete multiplied by probability of getting capital T in female gamete. That comes out to be 1/4. So we have seen this in the Punnett square, and we have to learn it for solving the question. So all the probabilities you need to learn. So if the parents are heterozygous, the probability of getting homozygous genotype, whether it is small t or capital T, it is 1/4. So by product rule we can get it. So another is the sum rule or OR rule. It is also known as the addition rule. So this rule is applied when considering two mutually exclusive outcomes that can result from more than one pathway. Okay, so two mutually exclusive outcome, we will again understand it with the help of a general example. Suppose we are rolling a die having 6 number 1, 2, 6. The probability of getting a digit 3, it is the 1/6. Okay, at the same time you cannot have 5. Okay, if you want to have 3, the probability is 1/6, but at the same time you cannot have 5. But if you want to have the digit 5 by rolling a dice, then its probability will be again 1/6. Okay, but then you are not able to get 3. So both the events, getting 3 or 5, they are mutually exclusive. If one occur, other will not. So these are the mutually exclusive event. And if we would like to say what is the probability of getting 3 and 5, then you have to add the probability of getting 3 and probability of getting 5. 1/6 plus 1/6, it comes out to be 1/3. Okay. So these are the mutually exclusive event. Okay, here in case of genetics, we will take the example of the monohybrid cross again. Now we have understand the probability of getting gamete with capital T and small t in both the cases, either male or female, it remains 1/2. Now, what is the chance that a particular offspring has heterozygous genotype? Okay, in case of homozygous genotype, there is only one way to get it. But heterozygous genotype can be obtained by using two different pathways. Okay, so what are these pathways? Either parent one will produce, one will contribute capital T allele, and other will contribute small t allele. Or parent 1 will contribute small t allele, and other parent will contribute capital T allele. So these are the two different ways, and the probability of getting this heterozygous genotype by one pathway is calculated by the product rule. Because I have told you earlier that probability of getting small t in the gamete is half, and probability of getting capital T is half, and both these are independent event. So what is the probability of having both the events? If these are independent, we calculate it by the product rule. So first we will apply product rule. So here the probability of getting capital T small t genotype is the 1 by 4 in one pathway, and in other pathway it is a same 1 by 4. Okay, so the combined, so what now question is that what is the probability of getting capital T small t genotype, okay, in both the cases. So we will have to sum individual probability of individual event. So we will make the sum of these and get the probability of 1 by 2. So in this way we can calculate the probability of heterozygote. Outcome remains same, but getting that outcome is different. Okay. So now we will understand the sum rule by Mendel second law, in which we use two genes and two characters. So here is the cross involving the two heterozygous parent for two different characters, height and the shape of the seed. So what is the probability of the progeny having tall and round character? Okay, so first we have to understand how these combinations tall and round could be produced. So there are four different ways by which we can get the tall and round combination. One way, another way, then another, and the fourth way. So these four events are mutually exclusive. At a time, one event can occur. Okay. If one is occurring, other will not. So these are the mutually exclusive event. And first now we have to calculate the probability of each event. And the probability of each event will be calculated first by the product rule. Then we have to apply the sum rule. So how will we do this? Whether it is dihybrid, whether it is trihybrid, whether it is pentahybrid, we will consider the monohybrid clause for each gene. So to get this genotype, we will first cross this capital T small t genotype with the capital T small t genotype. And in previous slide we have seen that when the two heterozygous parents in monohybrid cross, when crosses, the probability of producing homozygous tall is 1 by 4. Okay, and the probability of getting homozygous R by seeing the cross between these, again it is 1 by 4. And both these events are, means getting homozygous T and homozygous R are independent, then we will apply product rule, and the getting and the probability of getting this combination will be the 1 by 16. Similarly, in second case, the probability of getting heterozygous tall parent, it is 1 by 2. Probability of getting homozygous are round, 1 by 4. These two are independent events, so we will apply product rule. The probability of getting this combination will be 1 by 8. Similarly, we can get the probability for next two. Now what is the probability of getting all tall and round. Okay, all tall and round will be the sum of the probability of each event for that particular outcome. Outcome is same in all the cases, but the method of getting this outcome is different. So we will apply here the now sum rule. We will add the, all the probability, and the result will be 9/16. Okay, out of 16, 9 will be tall and round. Here is the example. If you are given a cross involving 5 genes, what is the chance that a particular offspring has this specific genotype? Okay. So for this, again we have to apply the monohybrid cross first for each gene. If we cross this genotype parent with this genotype parent, probability of getting this combination will be 1. Okay, we have seen in our second slide. Then probability of getting this combination by crossing this is the 1/4. So all these outcome are the result of the independent event. So we will apply product rule here, okay, and we'll get the result. Okay, so you have to try it and get the result. Now third is the binomial expansion equation, and this represents all the possibilities for a given set of unordered events. Okay, so what are unordered events? We will see in next slide with our example. So there is specific formula for getting the probability. The formula is probability is equal to n factorial divided by x factorial and n minus x factorial multiply by probability of x and the probability of q. Okay, and their powers. And what is the meaning of factorial? Factorial means the product of all the integers from n down to 1. Means if we are taking the factorial of 4, then down to 4 all the integer will be involved for the multiplication, that is 4 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1. So this is the factorial. And we know that p plus q is always 1. So there is the example. So if two heterozygous brown-eyed individuals have 5 children, what is the probability that two of the couple 5 children will have blue eye? So here total event 5, unordered event 5. Means unordered kyun keh rahe hain? Because blue eye baby can occur at any position, either first, second, third, fourth, five. So there is no order that first two babies will be blue eyes and next three will be brown eyes. So this is an unordered event. And event in one category, blue eyes 2, okay, and probability of getting blue eye, now we have well watched with this, probability of getting blue eyes is 1/4. You can see homozygous recessive condition. And the probability of other category we can calculate, 1 minus p, p by 4. So now by applying the formula, we will get the probability of 26% of getting the children with blue babies. So this is another example. If a couple plan 5 children, what is the probability that 2 of the couple's 5 children will be boy? 3 will be girl, 2 will be boy. Again, total number of events, unordered event 5, event in one category 2, So probability of bias, we have told you that if there is a girl or boy, then the probability of each will be half. So probability of getting boy is half and probability of getting girl will be half. Now apply the formula. So we will get the result of 31%, that if a couple plan 5 children, the probability of getting boy will be 31%. So hope you must have understand. So try to do the numerical on this. Thank you very much.